Hello, it is Tuesday, December 7th, 2021, and please do not waste your time watching this video unless you have a very specific reason to watch this video. Alright, what is this? This is me trying to answer my own little question of does consistency... And yes, I'm biased in this belief. I do believe consistency is more important than intensity, so... But this is me walking my talk. Is consistency more important than intensity? It's not a true experiment, but what it is a pseudo experiment. So, you know, there's only me doing this, and it's just pushing it through. And what am I going to do here? I'm going to stretch out a little bit and then do a basic workout that gets most of my body. That's it. Not going to be a very intense workout, but it's been the workout I've been trying to, hopefully, can do almost every day. If not, every day. Okay. The kind of workout that's like, there's no excuse really not to do it today. What I'm trying to do is 4 breath cycles, 1 cycle for each repetition. First repetition starts with breathing out, second's holding, third is breathing in, fourth is holding. So yeah, the 2 holdings are holding empty and holding full. We're close to full and close to empty. Not really trying to go for 100% full or 100% empty. Okay, that's about all of that. That wasn't bad for 20 minutes, 21 minutes. All right. So I was offered some McDonald's last night, and I took it. Had an apple pie, a large shake, and a large fry. It was tasty. After that, I had some vegetables, some protein shake, some peanuts, and a little bit of pecan pie. Goodness be, goodness be. That meal lasted from about 6 p.m. till about 11 p.m. 5 hours. Nice and slow. Probably not enough water in the mix. Drink more water afterwards. And I think before. I remember from that Tom Brady book, TB12. I think in there he talks about him or the ghostwriter or whatever. In that book, I think there was something about not drinking water during your meal, not drinking anything. And that really perplexes me. But then, kind of got the, I don't know where, but I got the philosophy behind it. I think a friend of mine told me about it. And what it was is it doesn't dilute the stomach acids and allows for a further breakdown of the food as long as you don't drink water 10 minutes before and 10 minutes after a meal. That bookmark, you know, you want it to get as much stomach acid as potent on the meal as possible to be able to break it down and use it, I guess. But I'm starting to really try to push my water intake. And even though this workout, I didn't drink a lot of water, I think I might have made one sip out of it. But, you know. It's time for a good breathing exercise. What do you say? I say that's a worthwhile notion. Keep it simple, keep it on the fours. Here we go.
little cycle. Yes, box breaths, 4 seconds, inhale, or actually, I think it starts on the inhale. Yeah, it starts on the inhale. 4 seconds inhale, 4 seconds hold, 4 seconds exhale, 4 seconds hold. The holds mean both holding empty and holding full, almost. I'm not trying to go to 100% full, I'm not trying to go to 100% empty. More interested in sticking with the time. And that felt pretty good. It felt like shifting gears. I'm not very good at multitasking, and shifting gears is a weird thing, but I don't mind playing around with it a little bit, as long as it's in areas that are not 100% crucial. So yeah, shift gears, make things happen. Oh, thank you. Later it shall be.